Hi, my name is Reesan Gopinath. I'm the director for Veda Handwriting Lab. Often we say good handwriting or bad handwriting. You know, there is nothing called good handwriting or bad handwriting. There is only trained handwriting or untrained handwriting. The basic objective of Handwriting Lab is to have a 100% result-oriented system of writing, where the teachers and students follow a single and same pattern of writing. Let us first understand what is trained or untrained handwriting. The first part is the proper writing postures.
The first and most important writing preparation is that your sitting posture. Both legs should be parallel on the ground and we should sit straight. Meaning, you don't need to stretch much, you should simply sit straight. The second important writing preparation or scientific areas of writing is the distance between table and chair. Meaning, if the distance is too high, it affects my legibility. If the desk is too close to me, it also affects my legibility. So, what should be the proper distance between table and chair? I tell you, if you can comfortably place both the elbows on the table, that is the proper distance between the table and chair. Now, the third one is the angle of the book or the position of the paper or pen. Suppose you are a right-hander. Keep the book straight. And you are a right hander, the right corner of the book should go up exactly 45 degree. Meaning, this is 90 degree and keep the book right corner upward. So, it is exactly 45 degree. Now, if you are a left hander, the left corner of the book should go up. Now, I am the right hander. So, right corner of my book is going up approximately 45 degree and one hand should place on top of the book. Sometimes you must have noticed the child start writing like this, then they go like this, later they go like this, sometimes they go like this. This all actually affects the legibility because the moment you change your sitting posture, it reflects in your writing. If you maintain a proper sitting posture, you can maintain the legibility. Now, why one hand should be on top of the book? I tell you, the moment when you start writing, the book should go up. You should not go with the book. Now, the fourth scientific area is how to hold the pen or grip of the pen. Nowadays, most of the pen comes with a grip. This is the area you should hold the pen. Now, how to hold the pen? Use these two fingers, hold the pen here in the grip area, and the third finger should support the pen. And if you find a curve here, see, the pen should always rest in between the curve. So this is how you should hold the pen. And the fifth scientific area, that is again an important scientific area, is that the pressure we should give to the pen. Or the pressure on the pen.
Handwriting is a science. This is the neuroimpulses created by the brain give instruction to the hand. Hand only execute that job. So it is a perfect mind and motor coordination.
usually we give these copywriting books to the children. That is the biggest problem in handwriting. We give this copywriting book from LKG up to 8th standard. On an average, the child writes these copywriting books for nearly 8 to 10 years. But still, handwriting is a problem everywhere. If you notice, the handwriting of the child in copywriting book and the same child's handwriting in English notebook, you may find two different handwriting. Because in copywriting book, he copy and write. And English notebook, there is nothing to copy and write. Meaning, this 8 to 10 years, we are making the child to do copywriting practice, not handwriting practice.
Let us have a small practice. You may take a sheet of paper and pen and write your name as usual. Meaning, the first letter can be capital and the remaining should be in small. Please write your name as usual. You know, your handwriting is unique. Nobody can change your handwriting. But if we approach scientifically, we can improve our handwriting. You may write a word good, G-O-O-D, 3 times in small letters, at the same time maintaining with your permanent or own handwriting. There are many patterns of writing. For an example, some write in print style, some write in cursive style. But if you notice, majority of the people write in mixed handwriting. It is neither print nor cursive. See, the child who can join G and O doesn't know how to join O and D. So it is not an ability, it is an inability. So we should advise our children, either they should write only in print or they should write only in cursive pattern. They should never mix two different handwriting because there is nothing called mixed handwriting. There are mainly 2 patterns of writing. The first one is print style. The second one is cursive style. When you write in print, each time when you write a letter, you lift your hand. In cursive style, you should only lift your hand till you complete the word. Now you please look at your handwriting and say whether it is print, cursive or mixed. A single pattern of writing for teachers will sort out many handwriting issues. For an example, in a day of 8 periods, 8 teachers are writing on the board in 8 different styles. The child psychologists say the child imitate the teachers. Out of this 8 different handwriting exposed to a child on a daily basis, which one the child should imitate? Which makes them more confused. Now you make a slant and a curve. Look like a slanting grandfather stick. You make a slant and a curve frame. You make a slanting curve. You are coming back to the bottom and create a letter C. Just touching the neck and a descender and a small bond, you create a letter G. Same way, you make another slanting curve C, touching the necks and an upward note O. Another grandfather stick. Coming back to the bottom, creating C, another note O. And one more grandfather stick, C, touching the necks and a ascender and a tail, you create the letter D. I repeat, you are making a slanting grandfather stick. The curve is most important. The curve should be there. Then you make a slanting curve. You come back to the bottom, create a letter C, touching the necks and a descender and a small bond. G is created. Another slanting grandfather stick. The frame should be there. Come back to the bottom C, touching the necks and an upward note. Another frame, slanting grandfather stick. Come back to the bottom C, another note. and one more grandfather stick. C. Touching the necks and an ascender and a tail, you create a letter D. To create proper formation of letters, we must use frames. For an example, you may underline the letter G in first good, second good, and third good. Same way, you may underline the letter D in first good, second good, and third good. And please compare the first G and the second G, and the second G and the third G. Is all the three G's looks exactly the same? Or all the three D's looks exactly the same? The answer will be no. But you only wrote it? Why it is changing every time? You may notice those letters moves in clockwise, we get better grip. Those letters moves in anti-clockwise, we actually get less grip. To avoid this issue, we first put a frame, like a photo frame, and create the letter within the frame. When you make a letter within the frame, the formation of the letter will be same all the time. For an example, if you notice, if you correct one C, the same C is becoming A, D, G, Q, O, X, and E. Meaning, if you correct one C, you can correct another 8 letters. Similar way, if you create an I, the same I, you can actually create another 7 more letters. Chapter 6, Handwriting as an Art. We always say handwriting is an art, and we make the child to write. If handwriting is an art, we should not write, we should only draw. Let us have a small practice. You may raise your hand and you look at the tip of your index finger. And you may write on the air a grandfather stick, a C, touching the neck, a descender G, another grandfather stick, O, another grandfather stick, O, and another grandfather stick, D. Please write this on the air. And when you join this, you may make a grandfather stick without lifting your hand, another curve O, another curve O, and another curve D. I repeat, a grandfather stick G without lifting your hand, O, O, and another grandfather stick, A, D. You may now write the same good on a sheet of paper by using the same pressure what you have given to the air. The pressure on the pen should be the pressure which you have given to the air. At Handwriting Lab, we focus on legibility, neatness, and speed should be 100% in writing. Let us have a comparison between the first good which you wrote and the last good which you wrote now. Which good is more legible, the first good or the last good? Which is more neat, the first or the last? It's not that the first good is good or the last good is good. The first good is untrained and the last good is little bit trained. That's the reason we say that there is nothing called good or bad handwriting. There is only trained or untrained handwriting. Chapter 7, Trained Handwriting. In English alphabets, there are only 26 letters. Some moves in clockwise, some letters moves in anti-clockwise. Handwriting is an art of movements, or it's a movement skill. Here, you have to teach only 5 basic frames, 5 basic letters, and 5 basic techniques to the children. The whole concept of handwriting lab is conceptualized in this sheet called Manicule Memory Sheet. In this program, the child has to learn only 5 basic frames or structures, 5 basic letters, and 5 basic techniques. Once the child practices this memory sheet for a period of time, his legibility, neatness, and speed will improve 100%. In our methodology, either the letter should start with a tick up or a tick down for perfect letter joining. Chapter 8, Do's and Don't Do's in Handwriting. Usually we say, you write more, better will be your handwriting. In fact, writing more, we repeat the same mistake again and again. In fact, it spoils one's handwriting. But if we write correctly, that improves one's handwriting. We should never give a 4 lines to a 4-year-old child, because these 4 lines create a lot of confusion in the mind of the child. Another traditional method what we use in 4-line books. 4-line books start with 4-line and it ends in 4-line. But in reality, the child has to write in single line. So, the practice also has to be given in single line, not in 4-line. Now, I will give you a perfect example for image writing or brain writing. You must have noticed, when you ask some child to write D, they write B, or U, they write N, because there are 12 mirror image letters in English alphabets. When we teach these letters together to a child, some children will take the image of D and register in their mind as B. So when you ask them to write D, they write B. So this is a perfect example that hand is not writing, hand is made to write by the brain. We make the child to write first, then do the correction. Why a child is writing wrongly? Because the images in his mind is illegible, so he writes illegibly. If we put the images properly in the mind of the child, he writes properly. In handwriting lab, we actually use 5 techniques for that. It starts with a finger tick, then to a voice tick, then to the air tick, then to the mental tick, then finally is writing. Writing should be the last activity. So, to summarize, the basic day-to-day issues in handwriting are: A. Using copywriting books and creating and imitating tendencies or habits among children. B. Practicing in 4-line books rather than single lines. C. Writing more by repeating the same mistakes than writing correctly. D. Different teachers with different patterns of writing and corrections on the board. Or in short, in the absence of a unified system of writing in place, causes the major issues or casualties in handwriting problems today. Legibility, neatness, and speed should be 100% in writing. But if you write in print style, your speed is affected. If you write in normal cursive style, your legibility is affected. There we need a new method, a scientific method, which sort out all these basic issues of writing. Handwriting is a 100% scientific process. So it has to be approached scientifically. These copywriting books or 4-line books are quite unscientific and produce unsatisfactory results.
from Auxilium Kuttiyam. And I show my handwriting before I could be trained and after the training, and you can see what is the improvement. So I'm not speaking a lot, but you can learn that this Veda education is very powerful and effective, and if you can get it, it do a lot of good. Thank you.
And I'm a teacher in Sarvodaya Central Vidyalaya. And first of all, I would like to thank Mr. Srisen Gopinath and Veda Handwriting Lab for giving us this golden opportunity to improve our handwriting. Frankly speaking, I thought my handwriting was very good until I attended this lab. And thank you, sir, for giving us this opportunity so that we could improve the handwriting of our children. See, this was my first handwriting. And after this lab, my handwriting improved such a lot. You can see this.
Then you visualize the image in your mind. Then only you should write. That is the last activity, is painting.
This concept was first visualized as a pilot project in our school. I am also happy to say that it was one of the biggest achievements, success stories of this institution. I am also happy to be a part of this program, in promoting this program. And I hope this program will spread more and more so that our children are benefited by this.
ഹാൻഡ് റൈറ്റിംഗ് നമ്മൾ വളരെ ഹാപ്പിയാണ്. കുട്ടികളെല്ലാം അത് ഫോളോ ചെയ്ത് തുടങ്ങി. അപ്പോൾ അവരിപ്പോൾ ഞാൻ ഇടയ്ക്ക് റാൻഡം ചെക്കിംഗ് നടക്കുന്നുണ്ട് ഈ നോട്ട്ബുക്സുകൾ വാങ്ങിച്ചിട്ട്. അതിൽ നിന്നൊരു നല്ല റിസൾട്ടാണ് ഈ ഷോർട്ട് പീരീഡിൽ ഉണ്ടാക്കിയിരിക്കുന്നത്. എല്ലാം കൊണ്ടും ഒരു നല്ല ഒരു ഒരു മാറ്റം പ്രതീക്ഷിച്ചിരുന്നു. അതിപ്പോൾ ഏകദേശം
കിട്ടിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നു. ഇംപ്ലിമെൻറ്റേഷൻ ഓഫ് ദ ഹാൻഡ് റൈറ്റിംഗ് ലാബ് ഈസ് വെരി ഈസി. ഫസ്റ്റ് വി ട്രെയിൻഡ് അവർ ടീച്ചേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് നൗ ദ ടീച്ചേഴ്സ് ആർ ട്രെയിനിങ് അവർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ്.
Now our students as well as teachers writes well, and I am very happy about the handwriting lab also. As a principal, I struggled a lot to face the queries and tensions of the parents, especially about handwriting. Copywriting is actually a repeated others. Again and again, writing the same mistakes. And students are learning the same mistakes in their throughout their life. But this is a very good handwriting program. It gives a perfect solution to all issues, and it will enhance the confidence of the child. So I support this handwriting program.
I'm Father Minesh, principal of Chavara CMI International School, Amanagara. I'm very happy about the training session of this Veda education, and I believe our students will get the good benefit of this handwriting training, and I also got the feedback from the parents that they are really appreciating the training program.
And I suggest all the institutions to implement this in their school, and that will definitely help a lot of people who are having very poor handwriting, especially when they're writing English cursive writing. That's all. Wish you all the very best. I think you can make a change all over the world.
Thank you very much for all the valuable services rendered by Mr. Srisan and his team in connection with the handwriting lab. It was very informative and innovative.
Last year we have implemented handwriting to our school. Now we are satisfied with the handwriting. We got 100% result. Now myself, parents and the teachers are all are satisfied with this program.
We have organized handwriting lab for the students of standard 9 in the last year, and it was 100% successful event. So the parents, students of standard 1 to 8 also convinced, and thereby we are able to conduct it this year, and it is going on well, and it is a golden opportunity for all the students in the state to organize this handwriting lab in their schools also.
Handwriting improved such a lot, you can see this.